Now in this class we'll learn how to handle mouse over operation and keyboard operation through Selenium. Like say for example, in Flipkart site, when we hover to electronics, this is a mouse hover operation. We are just hovering our mouse cursor to that particular web element, and after this, this drop down opens. Like this drop down, or you can say this list open for that particular web element. For electronic, this list of element open. So this is what you can say is just a mouse hover operation. We are just hovering over here. We are not clicking, or we are not sending any character to that particular web element or doing any stuffs like that. We are just hovering our mouse to that web element. So this is a, you can say it's a mouse hover operation. So to handle all the activities of mouse related activities like double click, right click, and mouse hover, we have a class called action class, which deals with all this mouse related operation in a web page. Okay, now let's say
hello.
Yeah. Hello.
Okay, so I think you.
I'm creating a new class where we'll be learning mouse over operation. Just copy out. Even put and mute a lot of noise. Okay. So let's start with Flipkart. So once I open Flipkart, my first intention will be just to hover on this particular web element. So for that, I'll be finding out it XPath.
Hello.
Yes.
Sir, I'm unable to hear anything due to my net.
So here what is happening is we found the XPath for this particular web element. Now I'll be using this particular web element to mouse over in that web element.
Okay. So your screen is also stopped at that Flipkart site, not in that where
it's
you are writing
net,
the
your net is. Tuina, is it the same for you?
No, sir.
You are able to see this, right? Yes. Then it's your net is. So. So. This action class has non-starting method, so we are creating a object for the same, and after that I'll be using the function of the action class after creating the object for it. Okay, now let let me run this particular code. So you will see that my Flipkart site will open and my mouse cursor will just hover in this particular section and this particular list will open. Okay, let's run the code. Why this particular login is coming? I have told in the initial class, like my driver instantiated a Chrome with a fresh instance, means no cookies, no histories saved. So when we open Flipkart, it opens as like we are opening it for the first time. So when we open for the first time, it will ask me for a login. So this particular will always open, particular screen will always open when you run through automation because it's a fresh instance, no history are saved. So no login history for Flipkart will be saved here. So it will always ask me for a login. You got my point?
Yes.
Yeah. So let's start writing XPath for this. Okay, so this is the particular expert for this cross button. So we'll be using it out and clicking it first.
So now my net is good. I can see your screen properly, perfectly.
Okay.
So sir, can you please say another time how your mouse over all those things, these wave element?
This started only, right? The thing here we are doing here is we are just going to this particular website and mouse means hovering the cursor over electronics. That's it. And my list will open. Okay.
Okay,
so for that I'm opening the website and
yes,
after
sir.
after that once you open it in this automation, it is opening in a fresh instance, so it will always ask for a login because no history and cookies are saved for initial login. Okay, so I need to click this one first, cross button, and after
Okay.
I click on the cross button, I just have to hover on that electronics. So I stored this web element in a object WB, and after that I created an action class object, because all this method of action class are non-static, so we have to create an object. After creating an object, I just used a method move to element to where that particular web element electronics. So
Okay.
I passed it as argument WB. Then after doing a operation with action class, we have to write dot build dot perform. If it is a single action, we could just do it by dot perform, and dot build is optional. But if we are using two operation of action class, then dot build is mandatory. But you can also use it in a single operation. So I used it dot build dot perform. Okay. So to
Okay.
have a practice using dot build dot perform is advisable, because if you do it for a single action or double action, it will work for both of the
Okay.
condition. Okay. So always use dot build dot perform. Or else for this instance, you can just use dot perform, but keep a practice to use dot build dot perform. Okay. Now let's see what happens if I run this piece of code. Got an idea?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let's run it out. So my mouse cursor just hovered out to electronics web element, and the list
Yes.
opened. Got my point?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So for mouse over, we will be using what? Action class. Move
Action
to
class.
element.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, hello.
Yes, sir.
So what I did here is I just did my send keys operation using normal send keys of web element class. Now I just hit enter through action class. That's the keys dot enter. Okay. See, it worked. So what here I did is I just sent keys to that particular input search box using the traditional send keys. Okay. And after that, I used action class to hit enter, because I could not send enter through send keys. So for that, I am using action class. Okay. So for using action class, I use action.sendKeys. It has a command, it has a function send keys. The action class has a function send keys through which we can just enter, like we can just send keyboard hit, keyboard stroke to the web element. So I have to send enter stroke of the keyboard to that particular web element. So I used act.sendKeys, then keys dot enter. So what is keys? Keys is a class which has different static function for different keyboard operation from the keyboard. So keys dot enter, enter is a function of this keys dot enter. So what it will be doing is it will just sending enter stroke from my keyboard to that particular web element through my Selenium code. Okay, so here what it did is just you could have seen wrote Lenovo by traditional send keys, and after that, instead of clicking this search icon, I just hit enter from my keyboard. Okay, got my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, we'll be learning how to double click, how to context click, like double click the left key of the mouse and right click the mouse and drag and drop, click and hold, we'll be learning it now. Okay, so for that what we'll be doing is we'll be using Guru 99 demo site, because there you will be seeing they have created a demo site where you can just, there are web elements specific to the mouse operation. It's too hard to find a site where you can like search for all these activities in a single web page. So I just use the demo site of Guru 99, where there is a for dedicated web elements, a demo site which has a dedicated web elements where I can just right click to perform an operation, or I will just double click on that web element to perform an operation and to check that I am able to do it through my Selenium code. So here what I am doing is I am just performing the right click of my mouse, and here I am performing double click of my left button of my mouse. Okay, so we are taking the help of this Guru 99 demo site, and as you know it's a site where you can learn any technology. Okay, it's also a good site. Let's start with the what you can say is, sorry, double click and right click. So here for me I'll be doing right click, and here I'll be doing double click. Okay, so let's start with the code. So first I open the site. Okay, first I open the site. Okay, are you able to hear me?
Yes sir.
Then what I did is let's see what you have to change the XPath. See, see my right click operation got performed and my particular menu got opened. So this is for right click, we are using dot context click. Okay, got my point?
Yes sir. Yes sir.
Okay, so now what we'll be doing is performing double click. So for double click also there is a dedicated web element in my page. I will be just doing the double click operation on that particular web element through my action class. Okay,
yes sir.
Okay, okay, let's use this one. Control C. I just use it out here. Okay. industry. So what I'll be doing is double clicking. So once I double click, I'll be able to see one alert will open. Okay. So how to handle this alert will be learning in the subsequent classes. So for now, I'll be seeing that particular operation is getting performed or not. Double click. Let's run the piece of code. See, my double click action got performed. For that, this particular alert got opened. Okay, so now you are clear how to do double click, how to do right click using action class. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let's learn how to drag and drop. Okay, how to drag and drop. Let's see. Let's say, for example, I have to drag this particular web element and drop in a particular web element. Okay, so I dragged bank from here and I just put it in here. So this is what you can say, drag and drop. This also you can do only by using mouse. So for that also we'll be using action class. Okay. Got my point?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let's say, for example, for that, what I have to do is I have to open the URL first, and after that I am taking two web element object from to from where I have to drag and to where I have to drop. So I am dragging it out from where? I am dragging it out from, see, from here. I will start my dragging from here and I will be putting it on here. Okay, so I'll be using the express for this one. From where I will be starting and from where and to where I'll put it. Okay. See, so I'll be putting it up to here. My target web element location is this. Okay, so I took this XPath. So what I'll be doing is I'll be dragging the web element from here and I'll be dropping that particular web element out here. This is my target location. Okay, so for similarly, I created an action class object and I used a perform. I used a function that is drag and drop. Okay, hct.dragandrop, and I just passed out argument, two web element argument. One is from where you'll be dragging and to where will be like dropping out that web element after dragging. Okay, so I passed from and to, and after that dot build dot perform, then driver dot close. Okay, got my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now just let's run this piece of code. I'm just commenting out here so that you'll be able to see the operation. See, it dragged bank from here and to put that web element here. Okay, you got an idea? Hello?
Yes, sir.
So there is also one method that is click and hold. What it will do, is it will just click and hold, like click and hold. It is not releasing that particular web element. Here what I'm doing is click and hold. Here what I did is in drag and drop, it released it here in that target web element. But here what I'm doing is click and hold. It is just holding that particular web element. It is not like releasing it. Okay. Got my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this particular action drag and drop, I can also use click and hold. Okay, do it by click and hold. Sct dot click and hold the from wave element, then dot move to element. Okay, then I'm moving to the target element where I will be putting it, that is 2. Okay, then dot release, then dot build dot perform. So what I am doing here is I'm just clicking it out here, clicking and holding it, and I'm moving to the target wave element, and after that I'm performing release operation. So I just release it out. Okay, and dot build dot perform. So instead of using this, I just want to show the operation of these functions. So I just like click and hold how it works. So I'm using it instead of all this. You can just use drag and drop to show the operation of this particular function. I'm showing how to use it. Okay, got my point?
Yes, sir.
Will perform the same operation of drag and drop only, but see, the same operation got performed, right, of that drag and drop. But what happened is I used click and hold to show you how it works. Okay, so you got an idea, right, how to, like, you can say is do mouse over operation in a particular web page. Okay,
yes sir.
Let's say for example, once I write Lenovo here, I just want to control A, means it will select all the text present in that web element. So for that I have to send keyboard stroke from my keyboard, that is control plus A. Got my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So here, what I'll be doing here, I showed you how to just use enter from my keyboard using action class. Now I'll be using control A. I'll be doing the action control A. So for that, what I'll be doing is sct dot send keys. Here I'll be using character dot keys dot chord. Why? Because I'll be using two keys of my keyboard. So using two key means when you use more than one key of keyboard, you will be using chord function, because it will combine all the keys and sending it at once. Okay, keys dot control comma A. Okay, dot build dot perform. So here I just wanted to send only enter, so I just use keys dot enter. But when I want to send more than one keyboard stroke into that particular wave element, I will use chord function. It will combine all the keyboard stroke, like I have to send control, then I have to also send A combiningly. So I use keys dot chord. So keys dot control will be sending using keys class. Okay, and after that I'll be sending A. Got my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now let's run this one. Okay. Okay, so you saw. So I just used keyboard stroke function using accent class. So at some time it may not work. Okay. So for dedicated keyboard stroke operation, we have a class that is called robot class. Accent also provide an option which I showed you, but sometimes it may work, it may not work, because Accent main motive is to handle mouse operation. To handle keyboard operation, we have one class that is called robot class. Okay. Let's say for example, after opening Flipkart, okay, I just want to open okay. So after opening Flipkart, I just want to open a new tab. So what I'll be pressing? Control plus T. Once I press Control plus T from keyboard, a new tab will get opened. So
Yes, sir.
this is purely a what? Keyboard operation. So to deal mouse operation, I have action class. To deal with keyboard operation, I have robot class. Okay. But here also it give an option in action class to perform keyboard operation, but at some time it may not work properly, right? So to deal with that, we will be using robot class. It is a dedicated class, so it will work properly. Okay, let's say for example, after clicking the cross button, what I do is let's comment out all these functions. Source I'll be creating object of robot class because it has a non-starting method. Okay. Now what here I did is I created an object of robot class. After that I did is add dot key press. What it will do is it will press the control key of my keyboard, and after that I press T. So what I send is control T. So it will open a new tab. But what you have to keep in mind here is that once your operation is over, you just release that key which you have pressed, because if you don't release it and do the next line of execution, it will perform the execution with the keyboard being pressed, so you will get upset result. Okay, so once your operation is over, you have to release that key, because once you write r dot key press means it keep on pressing that key for until you release it. Okay, so after you don't release and perform next line of execution, so it will perform absurd result with because it will be having the keyboard key as pressed. So once your operation is over, you the immediate step is you have to release it out. Okay, so what I did is here is control plus T, so it just opened a new tab and my operation is over. I just perform the release operation of that particular keys which I have pressed. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let's run this piece of code. Let's see what happens. See, my new tab got opened. Control plus T operation performed successfully. Got my point?
Yes, sir.
So what you saw here is that although we have an option of using keyboard operation through action class, which is dedicated for mouse operation, it may happen that sometime it may not work. Like for example, I saw it for here when I sent control A, it just sent A instead of control A. So for in that case, what I best thing is to use robot class once you are dealing with keyboard operations, because it is a dedicated class for keyboard operations, so it will work properly. Okay, got my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is pretty much like how you could handle mouse operations and keyboard operations. So once you are having an means idea to control mouse operation, you just use action class, and while handling keyboard operation, you just use robot class.
Yes, sir.
Although action class provide an option to handle keyboard operation, but it may not work, it may work. So always go with robot class for handling keyboard operations. And for mouse operations, go with action class.
Yes, sir.
Got my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay.